This is me, Sneha, and welcome back to yet another video. So, I saw this article in Cosmopolitan a few days back and I was like, yes, it's meant for us. And I thought of making a video on it. So basically, this article is based on the different fashion aesthetics that are popular in 2021. And I was like, yes, I have to do this video because there are many people who have this kind of misconception that we can't wear the trends in real life. So if you want to be trendy, at the same point of time, you want to feel comfortable in what you're wearing, then this is the perfect video for you. We're going to be exploring some fashion aesthetics that are comfortable, wearable, how you can style it, and how you can add your own touch. So if you're interested, then continue watching. And without any further ado, let's get into the video. Alright you guys, so the first aesthetic that we are going to be talking about is the grunge aesthetic. Now this is the easiest aesthetic that you can pull off. It's comfortable and at the same point of time, we must have worn it in our daily life. But shayad hume wo pata hi nahi tha that it is an aesthetic. So what you have to do is you have to wear a monochrome outfit. A black on black, you can wear black spaghetti, black top with black jeans. Honestly, I would suggest you to wear black tank top along with black jeans or black track pants. And you just have to layer it with your dad's favorite, our favorite part of our dad's clothes, that is shirt. So you have to just pick a good checkered shirt and you have to just pull it off. And that's it. You can wear white sneakers and it would look so damn good. And honestly, for an airport look, this is the best that you can do. I love this. This is so comfortable and at the same point of time, so easy to do, right? Hey, you guys. So moving on to the next aesthetic. It is actually called artsy aesthetic. So artsy aesthetic basically refers to art. Anything that which has art inflicted on it is known as artsy aesthetic. Now honestly, I have seen a lot of pins on this on Pinterest, but I couldn't find something that's comfortable and at the same time wearable than this dress. This is a very long dress and at the same point of time, this has so good detailing. It definitely highlights the entire artsy project of the aesthetic and I definitely love this dress. You can wear it, you can purchase any sort of artsy print clothes. If you aren't comfortable with wearing print on print, then you can definitely invest in a good dress as I have and I absolutely love it. Pairing it with black heels makes it look even more elegant. Okay you guys, moving on to the third aesthetic, which is the soft girl. Now honestly, all of us are soft girls in itself, soft by heart. But talking about the aesthetic, it basically turns out to all pink, all BB pinks and basically the girly colors that we all love. BB pinks, pastels are their vibe. Frocks, dresses, they loved it. So I thought that why not pick this aesthetic because this is so easy to pull off. And at the same point of time, I think this is the most comfortable aesthetic. So let's see how we carry it out. Talking about the dress that you can wear anything that is pink or pastel. I have worn this very pretty frock along with my favorite nude heels. And I personally would suggest to do the same, to go for heels. Block heels are the best in that case. And talking about the aesthetic, they turn out to pastels or nude, so you can also prefer nude heels. And I think this turned out pretty good and this is something that we all can wear. It's comfortable, it's wearable and at the same point of time, I love it. Okay you guys, moving on to the next aesthetic, we have the one and only the baddie aesthetic. Now honestly, when I think about it, I'm like, no, I don't want to do it. But when I found some pins related to it, they are so good and so cool. Now basically, baddie aesthetic is known for the entire over distressed jeans along with tank top and overhead with a jacket. Now why I love this aesthetic is because it gives me certain cool vibes and at the same point of time, their poses are on point. Talking about the personal edit, what I did was I wore this over distressed jeans that I have. In case you aren't comfortable with this, you can wear the normal distressed jeans. Zaruri nahi hai ki bahut zyada distressed hi pehna hai. Along with that, you can wear your tank top, white, black, your choice, and a jacket, and you're simply done. It's so easy. You can pair it up with sunglasses if you want to, and you're done with it. Okay, you guys, moving on to the last aesthetic. Now, why couldn't I pick those dreamy pictures that we see on Instagram, along with garden or flowers, those kind of mystical pictures? That is what called cottage aesthetic. It basically refers to wearing long maxi dresses and posing. And that's it. It looks so mystical and so dreamy. So that's what I'm going to be doing right here. I have worn a super pretty green long maxi dress. The main motive of cottage aesthetic is to wear something that is kind of divisions of frill in it. That's what basically it refers to. Along with that, you can also carry a jute bag if you have. That's completely optional. And it's done. It's so easy. And you can wear it at any particular occasion. Not just to a cottage, not just to a garden. But yeah, this is so easily recreatable. And you would never ever know that you have actually pulled off. Yeah, you guys, that's pretty much it about this video. I really hope you guys enjoyed this and gained some information about different fashion aesthetics. Let me know in the comment section below what is your fashion aesthetic, and I would love to read all of them. Also, I really hope that now you would be able to wear these trends boldly and you won't be worried ki comfortable nahi hai, aisa nahi hai, waisa nahi hai. These styles are very comfortable and at the same point of time, I love all of them. Let me know your views in the comment section below. I'll catch you guys super soon. Take care of yourself, stay safe, like and subscribe, and bye!